time for the match game, Hollywood Squares. Power with the Capricorn MD, Brian Mitchell. From Too Close for Comfort, Lydia Cornell. Paul Provenza. Edie McClure. Jamie Widow. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much.
Here we go.
We welcome you one and all to the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. This is a marriage of two of your favorite TV games. I'll be hosting the Match Game.
And I'll be hosting Hollywood Squares a little later on.
No kidding.
Yeah, I think so.
I can hardly wait. Come over here. I have a seat on the aisle for you.
A great notion.
It's going to cost you $47.50, but hello, star!
Archie!
Hey! Aren't these beautiful people up here? Now, listen. We've got to do something special.
Okay.
We can't sing Happy Birthday, but today is his birthday. What can we do for him?
There's a card for your birthday.
Everybody give him a birthday card. There's another birthday card.
Thank you so much.
You're going to give him a little kiss for his birthday?
I want to give him a bunch of spankings.
A spankings?
Even better.
Uh-oh, the heck with the cards. You know. Many happy returns
thank
of
you,
the day
Jim.
There.
Thank you very much.
All right, Jamie.
He's not a cold
I love Bob.
You should read his card.
This is a great one.
Hey,
what does that one say?
This one says, match game, and it's blank over here. Just like, hey, Jamie.
I couldn't do anything.
Let's say hello to our two players here, Blaze DeRocco and Trish Burton.
Hello.
Hello there. Welcome. Blaze, tell us about you.
Well, I'm vice president of sales for a moving and storage company.
Yeah.
And one of the most exciting things happening is that 2 months ago today, I was married.
So well, good for you. That's an interesting name, Blaze. Shouldn't he be a movie star with a name like Blaze DeRocco?
So. Gene, we're trying to establish. Did he say a movie and storage company?
That's
moving.
Moving. Moving and storage.
Where is my couch? Where is my couch?
I'll tell you what I tell all the ladies.
It's all
what?
On the
it's not truck. My job.
It's not your job. All right, Blaze, good luck to you here. Now let's find out about Trish Burden. Another interesting name, isn't it? Trish Burden. Hello, Trish.
Hi. I'm from Bartow, Florida. I'm a dancer, and I just left a show in Vegas to come to L.A. and study acting. And to supplement my income, I'm a stained glass artist and a G-string maker, and I happen to have a G-string just for you.
Oh.
Put it on.
I don't care. It is your birthday.
Put that on your violin.
No. I'll put it on.
I know you'd like me to, and I'm going to.
All right.
They won't let me do that. But I thank you very much, Trish. You're a very kind lady, and we'll talk about this later. All right. Now, Blaze, you won the toss. So we're going to begin here now. That means you have a choice of A or B.
I'll go for B.
B it is. Love you. Are you ready?
I can't.
Sadie sometimes thinks she's her own mother. Once a week, she puts on a gray wig and asks herself, so, when are you going to blank? Everybody understand that? Are you all ready? You just put the right in there, Paul. All right, now we're all set down here. Blaze. Sadie sometimes thinks she's her own mother. Once a week, she puts on a gray wig and asks herself, so, when are you going to blank?
Get married.
Get married. I guess if somebody tuned in late, they'd think it's kind of goofy to see me walking around with this here. So I think I'll just stick it in my pocket if it's all right with you, Trish.
Put it on your violin?
Wait till I get home, yes. Since when have you been wearing that? Since my wife found it in the glove compartment. Okay. Okay, Paul.
Oh, that was a great answer. I didn't even think of that. I went for what my mother always asked me. When are you going to write?
When are you going to write? Where does your mother live?
Next door. It's a...
What do you say, Edie?
Well, you know something that my mother's been asking me for a very long time.
What is that?
And my mother's Irish, and why she's talking like this, I don't know. But she's always like, when are you gonna get married?
Get married. Okay, one for Blaze. Hello, Brian.
Hi, Gene.
How are you? Good. How are you? Good.
Fine. I feel a little stupid here.
Why?
Because I misunderstood the question.
Uh-oh.
I did. But I got the right answer anyway. Get married.
You rascal. Two for Blaze. She puts on a gray wig and asks herself the question, so when are you going to blank?
Well, when I was in Shanana, you know, my mother would always ask me, when I studied classical piano as a kid, when are you going to get to Carnegie Hall? When are you going to get to Carnegie Hall? And then finally, when I was in Shanana, I got to Carnegie Hall, and I was up there singing, ram-a-lam-a-lam-a-ding-dong, ram-a-lam-a-lam-a-ding-ram. And my mother was out there in the audience like, Jonathan, see, that's my son singing ram-a-lam-a-ding-dong. He made it to Carnegie Hall. It didn't make any difference. It was all the same with her. So I was lucky because that allowed me to escape the age-old question, when you're gonna get married?
Okay. Three for Blaze. You're starting off like a house of fire. Jamie.
Well, I'm already married. So I thought maybe it was, when are you gonna call?
When are you going to call? When are you going to, how come you never telephone me?
Never
what
call.
Say you, Lydia?
I can't believe that I got such a strange answer. Get married.
Get married. Great answer.
You and me. You idiots. You,
now, Trish, you've got a little catching up to do.
The same answer. You don't
here we go. Gloria said, my boyfriend has the biggest nose in the world. It's so... Sorry, your heart's not in it.
Yeah.
Nor are their noses.
On a scale of 1 to 10, it was a 3. It'll come up a little bit later, and you got to be ready for it. It's so big, he uses it to play blank.
Once again?
My boyfriend has the biggest nose in the world. It's so big, he uses it to play blank. Trish. Gloria said, my boyfriend has the biggest nose in the world. It's so big, he uses it to play...
tennis.
Tennis. Sure. I think it's a possibility, Paul.
It's a major possibility. Unfortunately, it's not the possibility. It's not the only one, because I think it's bigger than that. He plays golf with it.
Golf? All right.
Good.
And sure. It doesn't even have very to bend possible. Down.
That's right. Well, there's some good choices here. What have you got?
Oh, I tried to make a noise.
Go ahead. Give her a chance to make a noise. Make a noise.
I can't make that noise. Anyway, that's the noise I wanted to make. And then... Gretzky with a hat trick. Hockey.
Hockey. All right. A good one. What do you say, Brian?
Well, I'm having problems here today.
You are?
I am. I thought that I understood it, but I didn't again, and I said tennis.
All right, Trish, one for you.
Brian.
Hey. You're a wacky
biggest
guy,
nose right? in the world. It's so big he uses it to play tennis, according to Trish. What do you say, John?
I could be Gloria's boyfriend, I suppose, with the biggest nose in the world. Certainly the biggest nose on this panel, so I must have the definitive answer. Unfortunately, it doesn't match. Hockey.
Hockey is what he said, Trish. Jamie, tennis is what she's seeking.
Trish, it's my birthday. You didn't make me a G-string.
I have more.
In that case, tennis.
Okay.
There's still time.
All right. Where did that come from? Where did that come from?
Thank you so much. Put it on, Jane.
I'm not sitting next to him.
Oh, that really worked. Okay.
No earmuffs. All right, Lydia.
What an ugly hat.
All right.
This is a very off-the-wall response, but I'm musically inclined, so... And piano.
Ouch.
A long note.
Use it to play the piano, one note at a time. All right, so you picked up two. This is an interesting game here. 4-2 is the score at the end of the first round in Blaze's favor. And now we have this for you. Come back for round two, if you please.
There's something.
Here we go. On with the match game. Round two coming up. And Blaze, since you're ahead, you have to go first.
I'll pick A.
Hey, all right? The coach said, he said, playing football against the local police was a bad idea. They didn't just tackle our quarterback, they blanked him.
You're all right.
There we go. The coach said playing football against the local police was a bad idea. They didn't just tackle our quarterback, they blanked him.
Frisked him.
They frisked him. Well, what kind of police force was that? What do you say, Paul?
I say I would love to have seen the cheerleaders when he got frisked.
Ah! You're going to surprise me.
Where did it go? I figure if you don't have someone like me on the panel, Blaze doesn't get to play the third round.
Right, exactly.
So I cuffed him.
Cuffed him. All right, so Blaze, you're up to five. And let's see if Trish is going to catch up now.
Here's another round card, is fun. Jamie.
It's more fun this way.
Here's a sympathy card, Jamie.
Brian and Jamie do not play this round.
Yeah, you see, I got this one.
Yeah.
I don't play.
Liz Taylor is starring in a remake of Cat on a Hot Tin Roof. This time they're calling it Blank on a Hot Tin Roof.
Can I check with the legal department first?
Yes. You want to whisper in my ear and get a little guidance?
I'm afraid to even come over here.
Let's see what Bowman's right. John Bowman's right.
Okay, Paul's ready, so we'll come over to Trish. Liz Taylor is starring in a remake of Cat on a Hot Tin Roof. This time they're calling it Blank on a Hot Tin Roof.
Oh, I don't want to be rude.
Go ahead.
You want to win?
Wait a minute.
Go ahead.
Look at him. Remember what they told you about playing this game.
Okay, here we go. Fat on a hot tin roof?
Fat on a hot tin roof? She says fat on a hot tin roof, but she says that's not nice. What do you say?
You don't know what's not nice.
Pig!
You're right.
Inverted pig.
Oh, I'm really? So glad you don't have to do this. Oh.
Yeah. Hello,
she's
Edie.
The future Mrs. Provenza. I beg your pardon.
Not anymore, she's
yeah.
I don't know week. Why they say those things about me.
Fat. Tin roof. All right. Here we go. Wait a minute. John, hello
yeah.
there. Yeah, we've got you.
Here I am.
This time they're calling it blank on a hot tin roof. She said fat on a hot tin roof. What do you say?
Yes, she went for the rhyme, and I went for the alliteration. Cat on a hot tin roof. I said cow on a hot tin roof. I'm sorry, Liz.
I like that answer, John.
I'm sorry, Liz. I'm sorry. True.
I like that answer.
Hello there, Jamie.
No.
Oh,
no,
you skip write. You. And Lydia, what do you say?
I'd really rather you didn't pick
up. All right, we'll pass, Lydia. No, we can't do that. No, you must show and tell.
We're into Barnyard Animal. This is a different one. Oh, I feel terrible, Liz. Moose.
Oh. Ooh.
It's a tough
one. All right. Here's the end of round two, and here's where we are at round two. 5-3. And the third and final round is coming up in a moment or so. First, this for you.
This is not a...
Here we go with the third and final round. And Blaze, you're still ahead, so you have to go first.
Okay, I'll take B.
All right. Now, this is a special question only for the birthday boy.
No.
Are you ready, birthday boy?
Here.
All right.
Present.
Pops Periwinkle said, when you're my age, you don't take chances. That's why instead of a car, I drive a... Excuse me, sir. Understand it?
When you're my age, you don't drive it. Don't take chances. That's why instead of a car...
I drive a blank.
I drive a blank.
Right. When you're my age, you don't take chances. That's why instead of a car, I drive a blank.
You can't copy any of us.
All right, he's ready, Blaze.
You blew it.
Pops Periwinkle said, when you're my age, you don't take chances. That's why instead of a car, I drive a blank.
Skateboard?
Skateboard?
I don't know what to say. I was thinking horse and buggy or something.
How did he get five? You see, he's...
This one's my fault, Jamie. Yeah.
If he were on a skateboard...
I know, it's dangerous.
Sure,
I know,
he would be taking a chance. Well, all right, that's his answer.
He's just trying to make Jamie feel better.
Right. He said skateboard. What do you say to that, Jamie?
I say very interesting. And I say wheelchair.
Wheelchair.
Okay.
That would be safe.
Thank you very much.
That's better.
Ambulance, something like that. Now, yeah. Trish, you need 2 to tie and 3 to win. Don't give up hope. Here we go. Rodney Dangerfield said.
Hey, I'll tell you.
It's Paul, John, and Lydia. 3 people. Rodney Dangerfield said, I don't get no respect. Does anybody do Dangerfield?
Yeah, I don't get no respect.
Hey, Dangerfield, do it.
I'll tell you, I don't get no respect. Boy, when I walked into the store and asked the clerk to see something cheap, he showed me a picture of my blank.
And away to go, Rodney.
Two and a half on that one. It's John. He's funny. He's really
you
funny.
Said it. Okay, Lydia's ready. Trish. He said, I don't get no respect. You know Rodney Dangerfield. You probably worked with him. When I walked into the store and asked the clerk to see something cheap, he showed me a picture of my blank.
Wife?
Wife. Take my wife, please. That's his famous trademark. Now, you know his famous...
I'll tell you, Trish, you're disappointing me. Why, he showed me a picture of myself.
Uh-huh. Oh, all right. Yeah. Now, you must match both John and Lydia to stay in the game and achieve a tie. All right, John.
I really do have a violin, and I really do need a new G-string. And I'm really going to make you very happy.
Uh-huh. Okay, 5-4 the score. One more wipe and we get a tie here. Lydia, it's up to you.
Yeah, but I'm not going to make you too happy. Face.
Face. All right, so Blaze wins the game. Come on down, Blaze. All right, hang around here if you would a moment or so. It means you're going to go on to play Hollywood Squares. But first, we've got to say goodbye to Fishbird. Many thanks for the G-string, and good luck to you. We're going to send you some gifts in return. Trish Burden, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being on the Match Game. All right. Now, Blaze, it's time to switch to Hollywood Squares. We're going to bring 3 more celebrities out here. Here comes the rest of our set. There it is. Stop. Boing. There it is. I'm going to change places with the host of Hollywood Squares, John Bauman. We ask you to stick around here with lots more excitement coming up here. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Hitachi's 13-inch diagonal table model color TV, 100% solid state, low power consumption, special signal tracker system, memory fine tuning, 70-position UHF tuner furnished by Hitachi. And now, it's time for more of The Match Game. Hollywood Square, our with from Days of Our Lives, Gloria Loring. From Three's Company, Richard Klein. And Marty Cohen. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bauman.
Welcome to the second half of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. And with me is Blaze DeRocco, who has somehow wended his way through the Match Game competition. Also with me, 3 new celebrities, Richard, Gloria, and Marty. Yay! Gloria Loring, how are things on Days of Our Lives?
They're just fine. I've been busy with that, and I just finished publishing a cookbook. I went to all the cast members on Days of Our Lives and collected recipes, and all the money from the cookbook is going to a charity. And this is actually the volume 2 of the cookbook, so looking forward to it doing as well as the first one.
Yeah, terrific. Well, Blaze, I'm sure you hope to be cooking here on Hollywood Squares. Let's go over here, get right into action. And the first thing we're going to do is meet our defending champion, who is Lisa Gold. Lisa. You're returning with $4,100. Congratulations. Tell us a little bit about yourself, just as a reminder.
Okay, I was raised in Tampa, Florida, and I now live in Santa Monica, California, and I've been on the show 2 days, and I'm still single.
So not as if we haven't tried, yes. Terrific. Well, I'm sure you're hoping to go home with still more Tampa Bay Bucks, Lisa.
Yay!
And we're going to play Hollywood Squares until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever's ahead at that time is the winner, goes on to play our super match for up to $30,000. Now, our first game is worth $100 plus $25 for every square that either of you captures. Our champion has the privilege of starting. That is you, Lisa. Pick a square.
Take the usual. Edie, please.
Oh, thank you.
Edie McClurg. In a Playgirl interview, Edie, actress Margot Kidder said she has romantic fantasies about this man. Is he Christopher Reeve, Dan Rather, or Fidel Castro?
The play interview.
Playgirl interview.
Oh, Playgirl.
Playgirl.
She is a news nut, and I'm going to tell you that it's Dan Rather.
Okay, so Edie says that Margot Kidder has fantasies about Dan Rather. Agree or disagree, Lisa?
I'll agree.
It's Fidel Castro. No, you should have disagreed. Your opponent gets the first square and $25.
What a surprise.
That's news.
She was, Fidel's in the news.
She was impressed.
Speaking terms.
Okay, Blaze, your move. Pick a star.
Lydia, please.
Lydia Cornell. The Ms. Guide to a Woman's Health, Lydia, says it's a good idea to drink a glass of wine before you do this. Is it before you breastfeed your baby or before you make love for the very first time?
You know, I'm not going to fall for this. I know it's definitely the obvious. Before you make love for the very first time.
Okay, Blaze, she says that you should drink a glass of wine before you make love for the very first time. Agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
It's before you breastfeed your baby. No, you should have disagreed, and Lisa gets that square. Okay, Lisa, your move.
I'd like Jamie, please.
Atta girl.
Jamie Widows, you got a bad sunburn.
What's that?
You've gotten a bad sunburn.
I know. Ow.
Yes, most of it's on your shirt, I believe.
Yeah.
According to Self Magazine, Jamie, you should apply compresses that have been soaked in something. Is it tomato juice or oatmeal?
I know what it is. It's the vitamin D in tomato juice.
Okay, so Jamie says you should treat your bad sunburn with tomato juice. Agree or disagree, Lisa?
I'll agree.
You should treat it with oatmeal. No, you should have disagreed.
Oh,
and Blaze gets
it. That's right. I knew it was game.
Blaze gets the square, and Blaze gets to pick another star.
Gloria Loring to win.
Mm-hmm. This will win you the first game.
I know.
If you get it. However, if you miss it, Lisa will block. Okay, Gloria, according to Young Miss, is it a good idea to send a guy flowers, or would it be an insult to his masculinity?
Young Miss, we have to think the way a young miss would think. And I think that they, yeah, definitely, they would think it's an insult to their masculinity.
Okay, Blaze, for the game, she says that to send a guy flowers would be an insult to his masculinity. Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
It would be a good idea. You are right to disagree. You win the square and you win the first game. Come on. Congratulations, Blaze. Your name looks like Blase, but it's not, and you're not, because you have $175 so far. Our defending champion, 25, who will be right back with a $200 game after this.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
The bids get...
Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Thank you. Okay, our next game is worth 200 smackers and $25 once again for every square that you capture. Now, the last game was won by Blaze. That means Lisa has the privilege of starting this one. Pick a square.
Marty Cohen, please.
Marty Cohen!
Oh, no, it's worth 200 smackers. Well, is that money, John?
I suppose.
Oh, good, then I'll play.
According to a Glamour magazine poll, Marty, are more men turned off immediately by a woman who wears heavy makeup, is overweight, or swears too much?
Ah, this is a great question to have asked me because in college I majored in cosmetology. with a minor in eating a lot. And is a man more turned off by heavy makeup?
It's heavy makeup, overweight, and another of your majors, swearing too much.
Overweight or swearing too much. I think they're mostly turned off by real fat girls with a lot of makeup who talk dirty. No, but
seriously.
But seriously, no, that's crazy. I think what the real answer is probably smoking cigarettes, but that's not in there, so I'll tell you. It's, it will be women. Men are turned off most by women who talk dirty. That is really a turnoff to men. It's really
okay. So women who swear too much, he says. That's the biggest turnoff.
Sleazy. Oh,
agree or disagree, Lisa?
I'll agree.
It's by women who wear heavy makeup.
See?
No, you should have disagreed. Your opponent gets the first square.
Wow. Somebody.
Okay, Blaze, you're up to
Phoenix.
A flying start. Make your move for me.
Gene Rayburn, please.
Gene.
Me. Okay.
A question for you.
Right.
Gene. Yes. Scientists have developed a new vaccine that has already cured laboratory mice of this disease. Is it the common cold or mice herpes?
Mice herpes?
That's what it says here.
Word got around. I hear the mice don't do it anymore.
What a strange bar you have to go to contract that.
Boy. Common cold, eh?
Common cold or mice herpes?
Well, I think we're a long way. Medical science is a long way from doing anything about the common cold, but they are having some breakthroughs on the herpes virus, so it's quite obviously the herpes virus.
Okay, Blaze. Gene says it's obviously the mice herpes. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
It is mice herpes. You're right to agree. You get another square.
This is a smart guy. Right
Gene, can you get a phone number for me on that one? Do you know where that clinic is? I'm a friend. It's a friend.
Sure.
I'd like to meet a nice clean mouse.
Is that the National Enquirer?
Marty, why do you think you're in the
Okay,
top
Lisa.
Row?
Okay, Lisa, pick a star for me.
Edie to block, please.
Edie to block. You get this, you block. However, if you miss this one, Blaze takes yet another game. Edie McClurg, you and your pet gorilla are both pregnant.
I wasn't anywhere near the place. I wasn't anywhere near the joint, I swear to God.
We didn't get mouse herpes. I'm so glad.
You and your pet gorilla are both pregnant. Whose baby will weigh more?
Whose baby's gonna weigh more?
Yeah.
Eventually?
No, at birth, I would imagine. Mm-hmm. We're discussing at birth, mm-hmm. you know. I discovered in my course in neonatal primatology.
That's weird. That was my major.
Yeah, that was your major, but it was my class. And it was very classy. This is unusual.
Indeed.
Go ahead.
All right. Even though gorillas will weigh more after they have attained their full growth, and they are born more hairy than human beings.
Yes.
Actually, at birth, because they are able to speak, eat, talk, do everything more quickly than gorillas, and
Please
gorillas never speak, as a matter of fact. The
time's up. I'm sorry.
Human baby gonna weigh more.
What?
Really?
Human baby. My baby.
Okay, Lisa. This I think is for you to block, as I remember. And Edie said
a long time ago, I know.
Edie said that the human baby will weigh more than the gorilla baby. Agree or disagree, Lisa?
I agree.
And your baby will weigh more. That is right. You get the square and you block. It's an average of 7 pounds for the human baby and under 5 pounds for those cute, adorable little gorillas. Okay, Blaze.
Who's going to breastfeed
you? She thwarted you over there and won Edie Square. Where would you like to move next?
Richard Klein.
Richard Klein.
Yay, for the top row.
I have an announcement. I've been recently naturalized as a United States citizen. They gave me a green card. I'm very... Thank you.
Throw it down to Jamie for his birthday, okay?
John.
Yes, Richard, which came first, The Tonight Show or the first birth control pill?
Oh, now I know that The Tonight Show is 20 years old, and they had birth control way back in the 60s, and it's 1983 divided by 4, carry the 2, birth control.
Okay.
The pill. The pill.
Okay, yes. So Richard says that the birth control pill came before The Tonight Show. Agree or disagree, Blaze?
I agree.
The Tonight Show came before the birth control pill. Yes, you should have disagreed, and your opponent gets that square.
I thought The Tonight Show was the first birth control.
That's correct.
May I contribute a little
okay,
trivia?
Okay, Lydia,
John?
Your move. Yes, Gene,
may
hold
I
on one second.
A little trivia to here. I was substituting for Johnny Carson one night on a Tonight Show, and one of my guests was one of the doctors who helped invent the birth control pill.
No!
That was in the year,
no!
Our Lord,
kidding.
1960, whatever it was. Isn't that
so
interesting?
It's all connected.
There you go.
Well, that certainly means that the birth control pill predated the Tonight Show.
Right.
All of which predated Hollywood Squares and predated Lisa Gold's picking a square for me.
I'll take Lydia Cornell to win.
Lydia Cornell to win. A very logical maneuver. Lydia, you have got a tattoo.
Uh-oh. How do you know?
Where?
How did you find
Let's
out?
See
I
it.
Sat just two seats Show away it, from
Lydia.
You, my dear. If you're like the majority of women who have one, is it a butterfly or a heart?
Well, speaking not for myself, it's a butterfly.
Show us.
Prove it.
Okay, Lisa. Lydia says that most women who have tattoos have a butterfly. For the game, agree or disagree?
I'll disagree.
It is a butterfly. No, you should have agreed. Your opponent gets that square and blocks you successfully. Okay, we're going to be back to complete this exciting game in just a minute.
Your hate.
Well, so far I think we've learned that gorillas who watch The Tonight Show will practice birth control and won't have babies that are smaller than human babies and won't get mice herpes either. But one thing I'm sure of is that Blaze is in the lead. He's got $250. You got 75 so far, Lisa. We're in the middle of a very hot game. And Blaze, you have a place you'd like to move for me.
Yes, I'd like Brian to win.
Foul!
Okay.
Pressure's on.
Go ahead, Brian.
Brian, last year, were there more divorces in New Jersey or Nevada?
More divorces in New Jersey or Nevada? Well, Liz Taylor spends more time in Nevada. I'd say Nevada.
Okay, Brian Mitchell says there were more divorces in Nevada than in New Jersey. For the game, agree or disagree, Blaze?
I disagree.
And there were more divorces in New Jersey. You are right to disagree. You win another game. But what's probably of more interest to everybody right around me is that
Blaze,
it's 475 to 75.
Hey, man's on fire.
Blaze is on a roll. He's got our defending champion a bit under ropes. Okay, we'll clear the board. Move on to the next game. Now, Blaze, you won the last game. That means that Lisa gets to start this one. Pick a square.
Firewood.
Start with Gene Rayburn, please.
Gene.
Don't start up with me.
All right. Start with me. The November issue of Glamour magazine highly recommends this place as a vacation spot. Is it the city of Burbank or the island of Grenada?
November issue?
Mm-hmm.
Hello, Mother. Hello, Theta.
Very logical.
Well, working as far in advance as they must do to get a magazine out, logic would tell me that it would be Grenada because they must have prepared that issue before the recent troubles occurred there.
That's your answer.
That's my answer.
Okay, Lisa, he Absolutely. Says that it's Grenada recommended as a vacation spot. Agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
It is the island of Grenada. You are right to agree. You get the first square. Blaze, take a look at the board. Pick a star for me.
Edie, please.
Edie McClurg.
All right. All right.
Okay.
How does the American Dental Association recommend you brush your teeth? Up and down or from side to side?
All right. The American Dental Association... And I went to the school where they teach you to become a dental hygienist. If you go from side to side, you're just going to grind the plaque into your spaces in between your teeth. If you go up and down, then you're going to grind the plaque up into your gums.
No answer yet.
The least worst bad way to brush your teeth is up and down, so it's up and down. They recommend you do it up and down.
Okay.
She beat the bill.
She was up and down for a while, Blaze, but she finally came up with up and down.
Wait.
Do you agree or disagree that you should brush your teeth up and down?
I'll agree.
You should brush your teeth from side to side. You should have disagreed and your opponent gets the square.
Hey! When did they change that rule? When did they change
They're
that
dead
rule?
Wrong about that.
Yeah.
Oh, and that bell means the time is up. With $475, Blaze DeRocco, you're our new champion. Attaboy. Congratulations, Blaze. You have $475, and you have the opportunity to go over there, join Gene Rayburn, get ready for your chance at the big money.
Yes.
And, of course, we are very sorry to say goodbye to you. It's been a while. You feel like you're a friend, and
sure.
You're leaving here with $4,225,
yeah.
Lisa Gold. And, of course, with our congratulations and our thanks for being such a great player.
Thank you.
And now, Gene Rayburn.
John. All right, here we go. In a moment or so, we'll be back with our nine celebrities here. And we're going to have a go at the big money. First time for John up here. And hurry back. We'll be right back.
Now, here to play the Supermatch is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, sir. Blaze here has a modest sum of money of $475, but here in the Big Money Supermatch, he could win up to $30,000, shall we?
I think that'd be a good idea.
Well, all right. We polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this. Continental Blank. I remember the top answer is worth $1,000, the second most popular, $500, and the third answer, $250. Any three of the nine celebrities are permitted to give you suggestions. You may call on them one at a time.
Gloria.
Continental Divide.
Continental Divide is one.
Richard.
How about Continental Cuisine?
Uh-huh. Cuisine. All right. Richard.
And Marty.
I don't know. I maybe should be disqualified because I knew Blaze when he was just a little flame. So. But I would say Continental Airlines.
So you have Continental Divide, Airlines, and Cuisine from the Frenchman up in the left-hand corner.
Also
you may choose one of those three answers or give us one of your own. What would you like to do here, Blaze?
Well, the first thing I thought of was Airlines, so I'm going to go with Airlines.
All right.
Although
okay, that was Marty's answer.
And they're out of business, so.
Yeah, right.
So we could all be going home early, okay, Blaze?
Let's find out if Continental Airlines is up there. May we see the $250 response? Continental breakfast.
That was my second choice.
Aha.
Second choice.
Now, the $500 answer is Continental Divide. Okay. Gloria gave you that one. Here's the last chance for Continental Airlines. Slide the big one. You got it. Very good, Blaze. And away to go, Marty. Now, Blaze, so far you have $1,000. Now you're going to play the head-to-head match with any star you pick. Each star, as you see, has a hidden number in front of them, a 10, a 20, or a 30. If you pick a star with a 10, we'll multiply your money by 10. If your star has a 20, we'll multiply your money by 20. And there's one star up there with a 30. And if you choose that star, you'll play for 30 times $1,000. All right?
Yeah.
Time now to make your pick.
I'm going to go with Marty Cohen. We think alike, I think.
All right. Marty, would you grab your tab and pull it up in a vertical direction now?
Yeah!
Perfect! Oh! Wow. Oh!
Yeah!
Woo!
Look at that!
Gene?
That is the...
Gene?
Yes, sir, Marty.
I
hope I don't get electrocuted. I just tingled, I think. So I'm a little too excited.
All right. You are playing for $30,000.
Oh,
right.
No,
it's the first time it's happened. I'm so nervous. I can hardly walk over here.
Okay.
I'm going to get it. You're going to face me, Blaze. And, Marty, this will be a written response for you, a verbal response for Blaze. Here we go. Good luck. No help from the audience. This has to be an exact match. Here we go. Good luck to you. Leave it to blank. Leave it to blank.
Yeah.
You ready?
Yes, sir.
All right. Your job is to match him for $30,000. How do you do that? By filling in this blank. Leave it to...
Beaver.
Leave it to Beaver. All right, Marty. He says, Leave It to Beaver will match it for the $30,000. What do you say?
Ma, could I have a hunk of milk?
Yeah! First one on Jamie's birthday. We have a total on Jamie's birthday. First one to ever do it, and he has a total now of $31,475, and we'll be right back after these messages.
Here's how to get them.
All right, it's a very festive joyful moment for those of us here on stage, and Marty Cohen wanted to join us here. You look a little strange, Marty.
I'm in shock, Gene.
You are in shock?
I just talked to my accountant, and I found out this guy made $30,000. I'm working for minimum scale.
I think it's very appropriate since you want so much money. I've got a little gift for you,
right,
too. There's the G-string. Yeah. Thank you all.
But can you get excited next time you win? Would you mind?
Really, and in today's session of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, we'll be back tomorrow with our champion here and all 9 celebrities. I'll be here for the Match Game.
And I'll be here for the Hollywood Squares.
So long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Congratulations, Marty.
A member of our studio audience will receive Quasar Combines, a miniaturized radio cassette unit with a compact headphone stereo. The result is the stylish and versatile double play, furnished by Quasar. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.